second wave of missiles inbound. 10 seconds to impact. Counter with artillery barrage. We can't hit all of them. Brace for impact. Starboard side flood. Damage control. We've been hit by 2 sub-launch missiles. The ship's listing.
Launch them out.
We can't. The ship's listing heavily to starboard. We're sinking fast.
Continue with the launch.
But...
take them up. Hurry up with the catapult. Just concentrate on launching them. All hands not conducting aircraft launch, abandon ship immediately.
This will probably be the last time this ship launches an aircraft. So go ahead and pick the best plane we got in here.
Pick whatever you want. We'll catapult it into the sky. We're gonna get you up there no matter what, all right?
Captain, please choose my plane.
Captain, please choose a plane for me to pilot.
Captain, which plane should I use?
Is this the formation you want?
Rasgrease, launch!
Lost time and time again, but now I've finally won.
Huh?
Look, we launched them off safely. There's my victory. As long as they're in the air, I haven't lost. And I know they'll succeed. Yeah.
The captain was humming a tune. The same song I heard from the anti-war audience in the stadium. He was the one playing that record in the middle of a sea battle.
This is President Harling of the Ocean Federation. Attention, all Ocean and Yuktobanian officers and soldiers currently on the battlefield. Let us put down our guns and come out of the trenches. The Ocean capital of Alred has been freed of the people who took advantage of my absence to usurp control of the country. Once robbed of my freedom and of my ability to do the right thing, I now stand again under the light of the golden sun. And I do so with the honorable Yuktobanian Prime Minister Nicanor by my side. We have resolved our terrible and unfortunate misunderstandings, and the war is now over.
This is Prime Minister Nicanor, head of government for the Union of Yuktobanian Republics. Attention all officers and soldiers of Osia and Yuktobania currently on the battlefield. Please watch as President Harling and I stand shoulder to shoulder, hand in hand. President Harling's words are true. The war is over, but there is one more battle that still needs to be fought.
We believe that those who have tried to stir hatred between us are now preparing a weapon that could wipe out half of all metropolitan areas in either one of our countries. Our comrades are in flight as I speak, determined to stop this plan dead in its tracks. Which country is under the threat of mass destruction? That we do not know.
However, that is no longer important. No matter which country is hit, it would be a severe blow to all of us.
So now I ask you, members of the military, if you see it in your hearts, please utilize the resources available to you and help out our brave pilots. Right now they are flying east to meet the enemy.
To those who still dare to hide behind the power of their hateful weapons, bring yourself before the light of peace and harmony.
Damn it. How can we account to this? Max. Is the control facility destroyed? Please hurry. At this rate, we're not going to be here much longer.
We've come.
Ground forces from both arms.